In culture, we are reading Octavio Paz. It's like you cannot talk about English if you never read Shakespeare. You cannot talk about African Americans if you never read Richard Wright, Dubois, Booker T. Washington, Perry Douglas. That makes sense?
No.
I'm fine with it. Cesar Chavez, dedicated to him. And John F. Kennedy, who died in the spirit of Gandhi, Martin Luther King, etc. And Rosa Parks now. That was a sad moment. So we're all non-violent people. I mean, for a president to go visit a Mexican, you know he has to be very important. No? Try to meet Obama. Make an appointment. So the challenge again, you want to get, you see all the spirits, all the skeletons. He was the Malcolm X for Chicanos. He didn't believe in violence, but he believed in self-defense. I will start trouble. If you start trouble, I'm not going to run away from a fight. Real men don't run away from a fight. Chickens run away from a fight, and they get to live the next day. Real men stand the ground. That's why there's very few of us left. Luis Valdez, that's Shakespeare. So Juan Inés de la Cruz, the best Latina feminist. In the 1900s, before the feminist movement, than any other Latina, she even questioned the Pope of Rome. I'm not making that up. One of the greatest writers. She gives me the case of man for being male chauvinist pig, you guys. In her poem, an intellectual. She was in a room like this with intellectuals from science, astronomy, mathematics, physics, literature. When they questioned her, she was able to answer all the questions. And the priest came out with, the Jesuit priest, my institution, came out with one question. Several reasons, he said. There's only two reasons why she will have all that knowledge on her brain. Either she has the power of the devil or a gift from God. That's how powerful she was. Yes, ma'am. The wonderness that I proved. Right now. That's how we are. We're people of humor. But some people don't like humor. Tight-lipped. You know who they are. Texas. That's when she was young. She was beautiful, gorgeous, intelligent, beautiful brain. But she decided to not date any man. I'm still waiting in line. Already took a ticket. That's all of Central America tells me they rebel against oppression, discrimination, racism, etc., etc. It's the same enchilada with the Asians. They have a pecking order. Yes or no? It's Japanese and Chinese and Korean in between. And the last ones are the Filipinos. The darker you are, in the bottom of the pyramid you're going to be. Same thing with all ethnic groups. And that's called a colonized mind. With every bell of his time. So Latin America at the same time. It's in their genetics. It's in their DNA. They can't help it. Every 100 years, 1810, 1910, our extinction country was going to happen in 2010. Okay. Every bell. Latin America, South America, and sing happy birthday. Happy anniversary. Not in English. That's the Mexican flag. The eagle represents Mexican soldiers, the snake. represents the enemy. That Father Don Miguel Hidalgo, in Costilla, he did a lot of illegal stuff. I'm not kidding. He helped Native Americans learn trade, helped Native Americans learn how to read, write, and mathematics. He was growing grapes. He was totally taboo. Spain only wanted the new Spain, Spain for Latin America, to buy the wine from Spain. But he didn't care. There it is. And Latin America. All of Central America and parts of South America. It's going to become that way. You guys can read, right? Raise your hand if you're done. Oh, you guys want to read? Who's a good reader? Speak loud like me. Be a man and a woman that's not afraid of talking loud. Time to. Like my coffee. Read it, man. And then you're next, okay? Let's start with the next one, then. David Bosch. Oh, Native, Mestizo, Criollos are Spaniards that were born in the Americas. That was the latter. Spaniard from Spain, Criollo, Spaniards from Spain, born in the United in the Americas. And then Mestizos, people like me. And then Native Americans. Native Americans, Mestizos, and the Coyotes, Black and Native, were the bottom of the pyramid. So they were down. That's why those Miguel Hidalgo, of course, he got killed, chop off his head, and put him like a lollipop in the village so they could see him in downtown. Same thing with Morelos. Cut off his head, put him on his stick. You guys seen the jalapeno on his stick? That's what they did. Show the whole village. They question. Yes, Is this a term that you use for gringo, caballo? It's not negative. Gringo. In case you want to know, gringo is during the Mexican Revolution. Mexicans telling the American soldiers green. Green uniform, go! And he took back to it. Go back to your uniform. They rose to have you stand up. Okay? That's when we made the Native Americans 100%. And I had to sit down and have one person standing. That's how much of them are left. 1%. That's really genocide. And I'm not Native, just in case you get confused. The Mayu people who I work with, they keep calling me Native, and I keep saying, I'm not Native, I'm Chicano. But no, you're confused. You're Native. Basically, I just told you, they're still on the bottom of the pyramid. Like African Americans, the Chicano movement, you said, take one step forward, the system's going to bring you 3 steps back. And you go again, 1 step and then 3 steps. It's getting better, don't get me wrong. You see Mexican with that Mexican flag? There it is. Nah, it doesn't mean they want to go back to Mexico. It's just a beautiful sign. Who can read Spanish and English? Want to read it real loud, Mr. Por favor? Por si, por favor, bambina, por favor.
I was born in the blood and spirit of the courageous village of Hidalgo. In the year of 1810, who rang the bell of independence and gave out that lasting cry, El grito de Dolores, que mueran los patrocines y que viva la Virgen de Guadalupe. I sentenced him who was me. I excommunicated him my blood. I drove him from the pulpit to lead a bloody revolution for him and me. I killed him. His head, which is mine, and all those who have come this way, I place on that fortress, wall to wait for independence. Morelos, Matamoros, all compañeros in the act stood against that wall of infamy to seal the hot gouge of weed which my hands made. I died with them. I lived to see my country free. Free from Spanish rule in 1821, Mexico was free.
Was Mexico free? Very good. That's better English than Spanish that I know. I'm going to give that up. I could read, I could write. Don't ask me to speak. Once again, it's an enchilada. So, that war started, then the Texas War, then the Mexican-American War, then the Cinco de Mayo battle, and then the Chicano movement, the civil rights, Asian American movement, the feminist movement, the piracy movement, the war against Vietnam movement. And then, as you know, we're coming to the end of the world according to my people. Now, my mom is native. It's going to end on year 2012. I don't know if you've seen the film. In case you want to know when it's going to happen, December 21st is the end of the world. Doomsday. The sun will dry up and die. I'm not making this up. I asked my mom about the calendar. She goes, "Now, mijo, that's not true. They just run out of space on the rock before they continue the calendar when they got conquered. So that's where it stopped." It's happening. Volcanoes, eruptions, tsunamis, wars, all these diseases we're getting because we're putting cows next to where they grow tomatoes, onions. That's what creates diseases. You see, what do we call it? When the letters, huh? No, the disease.
E. coli.
That's what it is. You mix animal dumping next to veggies, whatever it is, you put on the water, and you guys are eating it. The biggest war is going to be water. You're going to be fighting for water. Now you're buying water, bottles. Never in my mind did I entertain I would ever buy water. Right? We used to drink it from the faucet and it was clean.
Not anymore.
All the stuff that you flash it out of the toilet, quote unquote, they clean it. And they give it for you guys to drink it. Okay, then the end of the world. Okay, here are the vegetables. Congratulations, Latin America. Congratulations, Salvador. Congratulations, Mexico. Did I pronounce that right? Mexico. I thought you guys get an attitude when they say burrito, taco. Is that burrito? Burrito. I apologize. I gotta get something to eat. Am I making this up?
No.
Is that beautiful or not?
No.
No? Delete it. Get out of los muertos. We're all going to end up there. Okay. I need you guys to stand up. You know what stand up is? I'll show you the positive evidence. I'm gonna light up some marijuana. Chronic stuff. I don't even know what that is. My neck is telling me that. Okay, we're gonna play the fourth direction. So we only bring the good spirit. Let's face that way.